I shouldn't feel such loss. La ilaha la ilaha illa.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the All Merciful, the Ever Merciful. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. May Allah bless His Messenger and give him peace. Dear viewers of Clearing the Mist, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah give you peace, mercy, and blessings. Welcome to a new episode of your program, in which we continue dealing with the pillars, the five pillars of Islam. In previous episodes, we have already covered the two testifications of faith, namely saying, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. We moved on to the prayer, الصلاة, and then we dealt with الزكاة. Today, inshallah, and in the next episode, by the will of Allah, we are going to cover another pillar of Islam, namely fasting, which we are already observing in this blessed month of Ramadan. Please join me and have a look at the screen to start our discussion of fasting. As a reminder, fasting is in the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is one of the pillars of Islam on which Islam is based, the other four being testifying that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah, performing the prayer, giving zakah, and the pilgrimage to the house. By the house we mean the sanctuary at Mecca, the holy mosque in Mecca, Al-Mukarrama. Is fasting obligatory or optional? Fasting as an act of worship, as a ibadah, as one of the pillars of Islam, is obligatory. The question may raise itself as to the persons who are obliged or on which fasting is obligatory or mandatory. Allah the Exalted made it obligatory upon every Muslim, man or woman. Then whether you are a male or a female, you are obliged to fast Ramadan. What about someone who doesn't fast even a single day in Ramadan deliberately? This is an enormity, and by enormity, as we have seen before, is meant a great sin, an enormous sin which is punishable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting, what's the definition of fasting? Fasting is simply the abstention from food, drink, and sexual intercourse. All day? Of course not. Only during daytime. And daytime is defined as from the first light of dawn until sunset, when a fasting Muslim breaks his or her fast. What are the things which are al-muftirat? Al-muftirat are the things which break one's fast, which if you eat or drink or do, break your fast and render your fast or fasting invalid. Intentional eating or drinking during the hours of fasting. Then if you intentionally eat or drink during the hours of fasting, this of course breaks your fast. If you forget immediately, when you remember that you are fasting, you have to stop eating or stop drinking, and your fasting is acceptable by the will of Allah. It is a kind of mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you can continue your fasting only when you forget that you are fasting. Of course, sexual intercourse, menstruation or nifas, then intentional eating as well as sexual intercourse. This pertains to both men and women. In the case of menstruation or nifas, these are things which are peculiar to women, of course. Then a woman in her menses, or a woman after giving birth to a child, is not allowed to fast until a certain period of time, until the menses comes to an end, or until bleeding after childbirth stops. Are all people supposed to fast? The answer is generally yes. However, there are some exceptions which are made for a person who is ill, who is chronically ill, and who doesn't expect to recover during the month of Ramadan, and whom a doctor, a Muslim doctor, who is expert in his field, tells the patient that it's dangerous for his health or her health to fast. Another person exempted from fasting is a person on a journey of about 50 miles or about 80 kilometers, one way or more, not double way, one way of 50 miles or 80 kilometers, or a woman who is menstruating or has just given birth, which we have just mentioned. What happens after these circumstances come to an end or no longer there? Once these situations do not exist anymore, the person must make up for the missed days. Those who have not yet reached the age of puberty are exempted. The aged should fast, but if they cannot and cannot make up for the missed days in future, then they are exempted and have to feed a poor person as expiation for every missed day. Then, these three people, a person who is ill, a person who is on a journey of a certain length, and a woman who is menstruating or has just given birth. In addition to this, someone who has not reached puberty around the age of 15, or sometimes if he or she has already reached the age of puberty, then he or she has to fast. If no signs of this have appeared on the boy or a girl, then usually the age of 15 would be the reasonable time for a boy or a girl to start fasting. Aged people, very old people, who find it very difficult for them to fast are exempted during Ramadan if they can make up later, if they improve and can fast. This is the better thing to do. If not, they have to pay an expiation by feeding someone for every missed day. Then if he missed the 29 days or the 30 days of Ramadan, he has to feed an equal number of people. What are the conditions of a valid fast? We have basically the intention, and the intention doesn't have to be made by pronouncing it. If you pronounce it, there is no harm in doing this, but the intention can only be in your heart. And refraining from things which break the fast, or refraining from things which are al-muftirat, the two basic conditions of a valid fast are, number one, the intention, number two, abstaining from all al-muftirat, all things which break the fast, which we have already touched upon. Are there any recommended measures while you are fasting? Of course, yes. What are some of these measures? As-suhoor. This is a pre-dawn meal in preparation for fasting. This is a meal which someone who intends to fast the following day eats. Pre-dawn, before dawn. Then the time limit is until the day break or the break of dawn. One has to immediately stop eating or drinking or abstaining from anything which is considered among al-muftirat. Then as-suhoor is highly recommended, and it is also recommended to keep it until late at night, because this will help you endure the fast, the hunger and thirst the following day. It is also recommended to hasten breaking the fast when one is certain that the sun has set. Once you are sure that the sun has set, then it's recommended that you break the fast and don't postpone it or keep it until much longer. Of course, you can break your fast. You can perform al-Maghrib prayer, the sunset prayer, and then go back and to continue your meal. But it's not recommended that you pray first and then go and break your fast. It is also recommended to be especially generous in giving charity. It's recommended to give charity all the time, but a special time to do this, or you are specially recommended to do this in Ramadan. And the Prophet, blessing and peace be upon him, was always generous, but he was more generous, or the most generosity from him came during the month of Ramadan, which all Muslims are also recommended to observe. Are there any other things which are recommended for a Muslim to do in Ramadan? Yes, to break the fast of others after sunset. And this means to give them a meal or to invite them to al-iftar, the meal which breaks their fast. And this is a kind of generosity, of course. And to improve one's relations with family and relatives. Ramadan and fasting is a very good time for people to get closer, especially with one's relations, like one's family members and one's relatives. Also, reciting as much of the Quran as possible is a recommended thing to do in Ramadan when you are fasting, whether in the morning or after you break your fast. This brings us to the end of our first episode about fasting. We will continue dealing with the other points related to fasting in the next episode by the will of Allah. Until then, I leave you in Allah's care. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. La ilaha illa Allah, la ilaha illa Allah. Most merciful are you, King of all the kings. Have ownership to all of each and everything. Indeed, I am your slave, created from the dust, a traveler in this world. I shouldn't feel such lost. Love.